Do you like the extreme faceted look of hand-carved craft store figures and or low polygon count 3D models? Do you wish you could turn any model into a low poly model? Well, today on the BV3D channel, we'll see an easy way to do it, and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello 3D printing friends and welcome back! Today's video lands squarely in the category of cool slicer tricks. We're going to see how to go from something like this to this with just a few clicks in PrusaSlicer. And you can also do it in Bambu Studio, Orca Slicer, and probably other slicers as well. So let's say you want to print something that looks like you spent hours whittling away at a spool of filament to create a work of art. What magical transformative slicer feature can take a smooth beast like this and reduce it to this rough cut yet charming character here? It's called the Simplify Model feature, and with it, you can reduce the number of polygons that make up the surface mesh until you get the bare minimum needed to represent the model's shape. Also, it's kind of a cool look. Okay, so why does the Simplify Model feature exist? Is it just to make cool low-poly models? Well, sort of. It exists to reduce the polygon count of models, but that's because some models have an overabundance of triangles in their geometries. And the more triangles or polygons a model has, the harder a slicer has to work to create G-code for the printer. So, it turns out that a lot of times, you can reduce the polygon count of a model without really being able to tell that you did it once you've printed it out. In other words, the extremely high resolution of the model wasn't really necessary to get a good print. So, the Simplify Model feature exists to make life easier for the slicer while still getting a good result when you print. And now that we know why the feature exists, how do we use it? Like this. We'll start with this basic grizzly bear model I downloaded from printables.com. If you want to follow along using this exact model, there's a link in the description. With the model loaded in PrusaSlicer, right-click on it, then click Simplify Model. That will show the Simplify panel. You can set the checkbox to show wireframe if you want to see the actual mesh of triangles comprising the surface of the bear. And you can slide the level of detail slider between the extremes of extra high and extra low to see the effect it has on the mesh. I'm setting it to extra low, which will reduce the number of triangles from almost 61,000 to just under 4,000. Clicking the apply button will remove about 94% of the polygons in this model. That's right, all those polys gone. Some people would stop here and slice and print the model, but I want an even lower poly look, so I'm going to do it again. Right-click, Simplify Model, Extra Low, and now it will only have about 1,700 polygons. Apply. But I want to go even more extreme. I'll simplify it again, and now it's down to just under 1,300 polygons. And that is the look I want. But what happens if you keep going? Well, once you get to a certain point, simplifying to extra low stops being effective. So, you can switch to the decimate ratio option and start dragging that slider and get extremely extreme. With this, it's definitely possible to go too far. Once you get below about 200 triangles, it's just too much to, bear, as the model starts to look more origami than ursine. But you do you, and pick the level of lack of detail that you want. Oh, one thing I need to mention. Since removing detail affects the entire model, it has also affected the bottom of this one where it touches the bed. We need to do something about this faceted barefoot situation, because there's not a lot of the back feet actually touching the bed. For this, we can use the Move tool and push the model down through the bed by about a millimeter. The slicer will ignore the part below the bed, which should give us nice, flat, bare feet when we slice. So, when you're ready, slice and print and enjoy your low-poly model. So, that's how to turn any model into a low-poly model in PrusaSlicer. This works in Bambu Studio and Orca Slicer too, and probably others. If you know of other slicers with this feature, comment and share your knowledge. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool with fewer polygons.